everyone, I'm Pabi from Pabs Kitchen. Today we are making one of the most popular dishes in Nepal, which we call kukhrako masuko tiyan. In English, we can call chicken curry soup. Normally, we cook this type of dish when we don't cook lentil or dal soup for our main meals. So let's start to make this delicious and aromatic chicken curry soup. Let's see the ingredients that we need. I'm going to cook 1 kilo of free-range chicken. See, it is already washed and chopped in 1.5-inch cubes. And I have kept in a strainer to drop the excess water. Here I have a jar with 4 cups of rice starch water. We call in Nepal Cholani, which I made in a traditional way that I remember to do when I was in my home in Nepal. It makes the soup slightly thick and it is easily available in every home because rice is such a common and necessary element in Nepal. So let's see how I made it. First, I wash rice in cold water like this and I throw the first water because it can have impurities. Then in the second time, I added water again. Then wash and scrub the rice very well until it becomes like milk to get starch out from the rice. Then here we have it. If you don't like to do it, then use 1.5 tablespoon of rice or cornstarch and mix with 4 cups of cold water and use it. Sometimes if you run out the flour or starch to make gravy or soup, then you might want to consider using this. Now let's see other rest of the ingredients. 2 medium size of onions, which I slice thinly lengthwise. See? 2 medium size of tomatoes, dice into small cubes. 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper. I have here the paste from 4 cloves of large garlic, 1 tablespoon of ginger, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, and 1 teaspoon of coriander seeds. I chopped garlic, ginger randomly and add it into the mortar. And I add cumin and coriander seeds. Then with the pestle, I pound it all together until it got like a paste. See? Next, 1 cinnamon leaf, 3 crushed cardamom pods, 3 cloves, 1 cinnamon stick, and 2 dried chilies. Salt to your taste, 1 teaspoon of carom and fenugreek seeds to infuse in the oil, which makes Nepali curry so different than others. 1 fresh green chili chop, you can chop on your own way and add to your taste. 3 tablespoons of spring coriander, chopped finely. 1 teaspoon of red chili powder and 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder. The chilies I'm using here are not too hot, so I'm using all amount, but you can use to your taste, okay? 1.5 teaspoon of cumin and coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of chicken masala, and 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. 2 to 3 tablespoons of mustard oil, and finally, 1 red fresh chili and 1 spring onion. I julienne it and put it into the ice water to keep it fresh to garnish, and I'm going to keep it in the refrigerator until I need. And this is totally optional. Please go to my website to see the full recipe, okay? I have put the link in the description box below. So we have our all ingredients ready. Let's cook. My cooking pan is already here on the gas stove. I'm going to turn the gas on in medium-high flame and wait to get the pan hot. Let's check if it's hot overing our hand. If it is hot, then you feel the heat on your hand. Now the pan is hot. Add oil and let it to be hot again. Now oil is hot. We can see the smoke coming out. Add carom and fenugreek seeds and let it infuse all flavor into oil or until it becomes dark. See, dark now. And remember, it is normal to see the smoke now in the pan. Now add meat. Mix well to combine with the oil. In a couple of minutes, you can see water coming out from the meat. Let it fry without the lid on until all water dries from the meat and oil separates. If you fry without the lid on, it helps water to dry fast. The meat becomes crusty and infuses more flavor with the oil. A After 5 to 6 minutes, we will see the oil separated and no more water left. Can you hear this crackling sound? It means the meat is starting to get sealed outside. See here crusted? This is what makes cod so delicious. Next, time to add the slice of onions, cinnamon leaf, cinnamon stick, cardamom pods, cloves and dried chilies, as well as green chopped chili. Mix very well and fry it until all onions turns out soft and oil separates from it. After 3 to 4 minutes, see, onion seems so delicate and brown and no more water left. Make a space in the middle like this, then add the chili powder and turmeric powder. If we add it into the oil and fry, it gives a nice color to the soup or gravy later. Mix well to combine and let it cook for 30 seconds. Look at the color, already looks so beautiful and smells so good. After 30 seconds, add ginger, garlic, cumin and coriander seeds paste and cumin powder, coriander powder, garam masala and chicken masala powder. Mix it very well and let it cook for a minute to cook all the mix of spices. Now add pepper and salt. Mix it, then add chopped tomatoes. Mix well. Cook it until all tomatoes become soft. Took around 3 to 4 minutes. See, tomatoes are soft, look so good, and the aroma is amazing. Now let's add all rice starch. Mix well. Next, put the lid on. It helps to boil fast. Let it like this a bit open to not to split when it boils. After boils, turn heat to medium. Then let it cook for around 15 minutes to combine all flavor to the soup. After 15 minutes, let's see. Looks so good. The soup is perfectly thick, see? And the color. Next, check a piece of meat. Then check like this with a fork. It is cooked so well, see? Now let's add chopped spring coriander. Mix it well. I'm going to taste. So good. Everything perfect with full of aroma. The next day this soup is going to be even more flavorful, so you can cook it in advance as well. Now we are done. Turn off the gas. Lid on again and let it rest for around 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, see, the soup is even thicker and we can serve straight away or later. But I'm going to eat now. I can't wait. I'm putting into my serving bowl. I'm garnishing with a julienne red chili and spring onion. This is so beautiful. And I'm going to eat with a beautiful plate of basmati rice and side dishes, stir-fried spinach, grated radish pickle and salad. Of course with red chili. Let's taste the soup first.
Delicious. Full of aroma.
And the meat?
Oh my god. So nice. The chili? Quite hot. More soup. Delicious.
So today we cook an authentic chicken curry soup. Normally we eat with rice. I really enjoy every bite. I hope you will make it and enjoy as well. That's all for now. I hope you like it. Don't forget to click subscribe for lots of more delicious cooking recipes. If you like to support my passion, please go ahead to patreon.com/pabskitchen or follow the link below. Give it a like if you enjoyed this video and to check out the link to my website for recipes in the description below. Thank you so much for watching and goodbye!